Buhari plans removal of Attorney General Malami, 14 other ministers. A top source in government, however, told the newspapers that Malami has begun moves to truncate the plans. President Muhammadu Buhari has finalized plans to sack at least 15 members of his cabinet, including the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice Abubakar Malami, before the end of 2021, Sarah Reporters has gathered. A top source in government, however, told the newspaper that Malami has begun moves to truncate the plan. The chief law officer of the country was said to have met with top members of the ASUU ROC Kaba to prevail on the president not to sack him. President Muhammadu Buhari is planning to sack 15 ministers, with Malami topping the list. Someone gave him the hint and he has started fighting back so bad. He doesn't want to be sacked. Moreover, he is enjoying the support of lots of corrupt politicians, including senior members of the Kaba, because he is assisting them to sabotage corruption cases, a presidential source told Sarah Reporters. Buhari had on September 1st sacked Sali Mamanam, the Minister of Power, and Sabo Nanono, the Minister of Agriculture and Rural Development. The president, in a statement after their sacking, said change in his cabinet will be a continuous process. 2 years and some months into the second term, the tradition of subjecting our projects and programs implementation to independent and critical self-review has taken firm root through sector reporting during cabinet meetings and a retreat. The statement signed by Femi Adesina, presidential spokesman, had read, "These significant review steps have helped to identify and strengthen weak areas, close gaps, build cohesion and synergy in governance, manage the economy, and improve the delivery of public good to Nigerians. I must commend this cabinet for demonstrating unparalleled resilience that helped the government to navigate the disruption to global systems and governance occasioned by the emergence of COVID-19 shortly after inauguration. The weekly Federal Executive Council meeting was not spared because the traditional mode was altered. As we all are aware, change is the only factor that is constant in every human endeavor, and as this administration approaches its critical phase in the second term, I have found it essential to reinvigorate this cabinet in a manner that will deepen its capacity to consolidate legacy achievements," Sarah Reporters had in a series of detailed investigation expose how Malami acquired several properties whose value runs into billions of naira since being appointed by Buhari. For example, the AGF has an underground hotel in Sokoto, 3 houses at Peace Estate Abuja, a brand new state-of-the-art school in Kebbi, 2 houses for his sons worth 100 million each, and a new hotel under construction in Jabi area of Abuja. Malami also bought a house in 2020 worth 150 million in the Gwarimpa area of Abuja. A newly constructed school located at back of Nitel in Gesa Phase 1, Beni Kebbi, and a new house worth 600 million on Amadu Bello Way, Nasarawa, GRA, Kano are among properties acquired by Malami since he became a minister under President Buhari. That is not all. Malami also built a 3 billion multi-purpose event center in Kebbi State named as B Arena for his son in Kebbi. This is apart from Rehan Hotel, located on Zaria Road opposite Aminu Kano Teaching Hospital, which the AGF massively upgraded. Ever since, Sarah Reporters published a series of detailed reports exposing these illicit acquisition, the online news medium has been a target of the AGF's camp. Apart from claiming to have sued Sara reporters over the expository report he said had damaged his reputation before the world, Malami also issued a petition to the former Inspector General of Police, Mohammed Adamu, seeking the arrest of the publisher of the online newspaper, Omoyele Sowore. Despite the open display of unexplained wealth by the AGF and members of his family in recent times, President Buhari, who ruled the power in 2015 on the back of a promise to crush corruption, especially in the government circle, has yet to offer any statement on the development. Observers say Buhari's silence is an endorsement of the atrocities of one of his most trusted lieutenants, Malami. Well, let Malami continue with his evil deeds. He thinks that he away with everything he has been doing, he will definitely get his Waterloo soon. So now that he has gotten a hint that President Muhammadu was planning to sack him, he is running ether scatter and looking for people to help him. Well, let him continue looking for them. Anyways, we all know that all of them, they are all criminals in Agbada. Whatever it is that is going to affect Malami, some of them knows that it's going to affect them as well. So I know they are going to try their possible best to make sure that this sack does not validate. Well, all these properties will be seized by another government the way they seized that of Maduke and many others based on these published articles. Malami corruption is modern. Desani, Maduke's own. Well, all of them should continue. God is watching all of them, and they will miss their Waterloo very soon by the grace of God. All these ill-gotten wealth will be confiscated when new governments come on board. Just imagine, all this money, all this wealth alone is enough to do to handle so many projects in Nigeria, can pay so many civil servants' salary. But imagine them, one person, all these things to himself without even thinking about how some other people are living. These people, Malami is the worst AGF ever. Well, and Minister of Justice, well, Nigeria ever had, there is a bribe receiver and a complete thief who had secretly collected bribe from Nigerians. He had plenty assets. Well, we all know how Malami is. He would definitely face this. Then we all know how the case of Abba Kyari was. He thought that he was God Almighty himself on earth when he was the so-called super cop. Now what is he? He's now a disgraced cop. That's what he is now. So Malami case will be another one again. So let's just watch, cross our fingers and see how this whole story is going to unveil and how Buhari is going to handle this matter. You can go to the comment section and share your take on this article. Thanks for listening.